Here's how we set up our dot plot. Here's my survey items, my pre and post data, and then a few extra pieces of staging information for the chart, the Y value and the label value, and you'll see how we use that in just a second. So we're going to go up here and insert a chart, and I'm going to insert a scatter plot. And there's not going to be any data associated with it right now. I'm going to adjust the size just so you can see it a little bit better. And then you're going to go up to select data here from the chart design tab. I'm going to add a series, and I'm going to add my pre-data there, my X values. I'm going to point to those, and then I'm going to push enter, and then I'm going to add my Y values, that 2 and 1 there. So now once I click OK, you can see the dots starting to form on line 1 and line 2 there. Now I'm going to add the post data in the same way, add the X values there, and then point to the Y values here. Perfect. All right, now you can see my pre and post dots here on these lines. Now I just have to do some chart formatting on this end. So I'm going to go ahead and I'm going to update the axis on the X, because I know that this is 1 through 7, not 0 through 7. So I'm going to make sure that the minimum is set to 1 and the maximum is set to 7. And then what I'm going to do is I'm going to delete these vertical grid lines. I'm not going to need those. And then I'm going to adjust my Y axis. Right now it's set to, you know, looking at point increments of 0.5, but I want it to be 1, and I'm going to set the maximum to 2.1 so that the dots, the full dots, can show up, and I'm going to select the major units as 1 so that the minor grid lines don't show up. So now I just have the two lines for 1 and 2, my connection to nature and connection to museum. And now I'm going to go ahead and update the size of the markers. You can do that from that format data tab in the dialog box there. And then I'm going to update this, both of these, to 20 points, because I'm going to fill those with our data label. So I'm going to go ahead and click, right click, and then go to add data label. And then I'm going to go over here to point to the X values instead of the Y values. Now those are my X values there. Those are the survey scores. And I'm going to update the text so that you can see it. Change the color to white. Do the same thing for my pre-dots. Point those into the center, and then update the text color so that it's white so you can see it. The dot plot is starting to look really good. Now I just need to look at my labels. Now you can see my X, my Y axis over here. I'm actually going to add a new series of data for the labels. And I'm going to update these cells to 1 and 1. And you'll see why in just a second. I'm going to go ahead and add a new data series for those labels. So select data again, click on add, and then I'm going to point to the labels. The X values, I'm going to just say 1 and 1 right there. And then the Y values, the same things, 2 and 1. Now you see that I have two dots here right on the Y axis. I'm going to go ahead and delete the Y axis. I don't need that anymore because I have these two dots. I'm going to add data labels here to the dots. And then I'm going to turn those labels to the left, and these are going to act like my axis labels now. And I'm going to point, instead of the Y data, I'm going to actually point to value from cells and point over to that connection to nature and connection to museum. And you can see that text shows up now in those data labels. It's a pretty cool trick. And then you can just adjust the text as you normally would, update it by maybe making it bold, updating the color, that sort of thing. And then I always go over here and uncheck the wrap text button from the text options format label. Wrap text and shape, I'm going to uncheck that so that it doesn't automatically wrap the text. And then I'm just going to adjust the plot area to fit the data labels. And then from here, you can adjust the size of the chart. You can copy this and paste it into your slide or your report. And then make sure that you don't have a gray border line around the whole chart. I go ahead and say no line. Oh, and I can see that my label dots are still there, but we don't need those. So I'm going to select those, go back to the marker fill, and then I'm going to select no, or I'm going to select none, and then those markers disappear. So there's your dot plot. Enjoy.